The main idea behind the CGM was building a modular mixer, a series of pieces that could be linked together to create infinite mixing combinations according to everyone's needs. There are three families of modules: the channels, the groups, and the masters. As of today, there are two kinds of channels: the channel and the quad stereo channel, one group and two masters, the master and the masterone. More modules will appear in the future, some of which will replace current versions, like the Masterone did with the Master. However, the new modules are perfectly compatible with the older ones. Some modules perform great as standalone units, like the Quad Stereo Channel, but they unleash their full potential when combined with different CGM sections. To build a CGM configuration, you connect the channels to a group, up to 8, and the groups to a master, up to 4. For this reason, a crucial part of the CGM design was the connectivity, which went through a couple of iterations. First, there were the link cables, designed when the CGM modules were all 6 HP wide. Then, after creating larger modules like the Quad Stereo Channel, we developed a more flexible connection tool named Link System. Just like the modules themselves, the various parts of the link cables and link system are compatible with each other. Today we will see some configuration examples with both systems. The group to channel link cables came in 8 different sizes, allowing you to connect from 1 to 8 mono channels to a group module. To connect the channels and groups, flip the module and look for this couple of IDC plugs. You will see that they are on the same PCB spot on both channels and groups. Then, take the link cables and connect the sockets to the plugs. You must ensure that the connectors are perfectly aligned, both vertically and horizontally, because a connector displacement that leaves some unconnected pins may cause fatal damage to the modules. To avoid ambiguities, we suggest keeping the red stripe down. In fact, once the channels and groups are connected, they share audio, power, and controls through the link cables, so it is sufficient to connect just one channel per group to the power. As you can see, the group is the only module that doesn't have a power socket. It is because it receives the power from the channel modules. In case your link cables have more sockets than needed, no problem. Feel free to leave them unused. If you have some spare sockets on your link cables and want to expand your setup with the newer quad stereo channel, feel free to do so. Its connector is located in the same place as if it were in the middle of 3 6HP channels. Still, the easiest way to connect channels and quad stereo channels is the new link system. It is still made of 2 strips of IDC connectors, but with wider spacing. Before connecting the plugs to the sockets, make sure to bend the cable to this omega shape. By doing so, you will be able to link every kind of module. Even in this case, keep the red line at the bottom and make sure that your connectors are well placed and not, for instance, like this. Or this. Once you are done, connect to the power just one channel per group configuration. The group to channel link system comes in 3 sizes, so that you can connect to the same group up to 2, 4 or 8 channels. You can purchase any of these link system options from our retailers by looking for these codes here. Even in this case, if you have more connectors than actual modules, that's fine. There are at least 2 reasons why you may need a master module. If your setup has just one group, you will take advantage of the complete CGM feature set, such as pre-fader listening, the master's auxiliary input, or the masterone's plethora of outputs. If your setup has more than one group, with a master module you can link them all and mix their individual sums. Back when all the CGM modules were all 6 HP wide, there were 4 link cables that allowed you to connect a master to 1, 2, 3 or 4 groups of up to 8 channels each. To connect one or more groups to a master using the link cables, locate these connectors on the back of the modules. They're in the same spot on every PCB. Then, plug them into the link cable's sockets, always ensuring that all the pins are perfectly aligned, both vertically and horizontally. The master module has its power plug, and the groups receive their power from the channels through the other link cables or link systems. For this reason, in such configuration, you must connect to the PSU just the master and one channel per group. Of course, it goes without saying that if you happen to have more connectors than actual groups, that's okay. Also, if you already have an older link cable like this one and you want to use a master on instead of the master module, you can easily do so since their connector is in the same position. Still, the best way to take advantage of the Masterone is using the new link system. The new Masterone ships with the master to group link system, which has three connectors. To link the modules, connect the first two sockets to the Masterone and the group respectively, always making sure that the red line is at the bottom and that the plug is properly connected to the socket. This is the default setting for a one group setup. If you want to connect more groups, you need to purchase one or more group-to-group extensions, which you can find through our resellers with this code. Besides the familiar sockets, this cable also has a plug that you should connect to the master-to-group's third socket. In this way, you will gain two extra plugs. If you need to link two groups that are farther apart, or if you need to expand the CGM to its full potential of four groups, you just need to get more extensions and chain them. Always make sure to put the red stripe down, or the extensions plug and the socket won't match. Even in this case, to power up your system, you need to connect to the PSU just the master and one channel per group. If you already have an older master-to-group link cable and want to expand your current setup, you can easily keep it and connect the new extension to its rightmost socket. Even if the CGM is a flexible mixing solution, there are still some things that cannot be done by design. Attempting at any of these may cause permanent damage to your modules. It is not possible to connect more than 8 channels or quad stereo channels to the same group, and at the same time, it is not possible to connect more than 4 groups to a master. It is also not possible to connect the same channel to more groups or the same group to more masters. Finally, it is not possible to connect the two groups together expecting 4 sends and returns.